Good morning, children. How are you all? Okay, thank you. I'm also fine. Welcome back to our online classes. Yes, in the previous class, we were discussing about the money lesson. Yes or no? Yes. Why you require money? Yes, to buy a things. We require a money. Yes, on this basis of this money only, yes, we can discuss one more topic. That is, yes, very easy. Here, see one example. Amrut ji runs to the ideal department store. He buys the goods. He buys the goods at a lower cost, at a lower rates. He buys the goods from the wholesaler. Who is the wholesaler? Here, there is a wholesaler. From him, this Amrut ji, he buys the goods. He buys the goods for the low rates, low cost goods for the low amount, or we can say low rates means less rates. It's a very less rates he buys, and then he sells the goods to the customer. He Amrutji, he sells his goods to the, he buys from wholesaler and he sells to the, yes, from here he buys to here and he sells to customer. He buys at a low cost. Yes or no? Low rates he buys and he sells to the customers with the, yes, some amount. With the amount he sells to the goods to the reasonably high rates. He sells to the reasonably high rates. With the high rates he sells. He purchases here with the low rates and he sells with the high rates. Automatically he gets a profit. Yes or no? He gets, if he buys a goods for 1800 rupees, he buys the goods for 1008 rupees and he sells for it. He sells for it rupees of, yes, 1500. Automatically he gain a profit. He gain, yes or no? How much? That is, yes, 300 of rupees he gain. 300 rupees he gain. This one we can call as a, it is a profit. It is a profit of Amrutji. It is a profit of Amrutji. Yes or no? Yes, he gain 300 rupees profit. If he sells this one 1800 rupees he bought this one, this we can call it is a cost price. What he purchased from the wholesaler, what he purchased from the wholesaler, amount paid by the Amrutji to the wholesaler, amount paid by the Amrutji to the wholesaler, that is how much he gave, that is 1500. He purchased for 1500 and he sold it for a 1800. Yes, he sold it for a 1800. He purchased only 1500 and he sold it for a 1800. Then bigger amount, yes, then we can, this is a cost price. What he, this, sorry, here this is not the cost price. Here what he gave for the wholesaler 1500, that is a cost price. We can call this one as a cost price. Then that is here 1500 rupees 1500. And what he sells, yes, to the customer, amount paid by the customers to the Amrutji is called a, yes, it is selling price. Selling price, that it is less, greater here. Selling price is a, yes, greater than cost price. Then only he will get a profit, 1800. This is selling price, that we call as SP, selling price, and cost price we call as CP. What profit he bought, that we call as P. That is P for the profit. P for the profit. How will you get this one? Yes, profit is equals to, profit is equals to, yes, profit is equals to selling price, selling price minus cost price, minus cost price. Then only he will get the profit. Here selling price is 1800 and cost price is rupees of 1500. Automatically he gain of 300. He got a profit of 300. We can call it profit or a gain. today we discuss the lesson, this one only about the profit and gain. It's very easy. What is the profit? What is the loss? That we'll all discuss in this topic, in this example. Yes? Take this lesson number, new lesson for you all. It is 13. Lesson number 13. Yes? Lesson number 13. It is profit or profit and loss. Profit and loss. What is mean by profit? I told. Yes, the profit. This is the amount which is greater than the cost price. That is, we can call as a profit or a great profit or a gain. Price higher than the cost price. The price higher than the cost price is called the, yes. First you write cost price. Cost price you write. What is cost price? This is wholesaler. Who gave the wholesaler? They made the price of their own cost price. Yes, then here profit. Profit is price higher than the cost price is called a price. Here, yes, right, profit, that is a price higher than cost price is called profit or gain. Profit or gain. How will you get this one? Cost price minus, sorry, selling price minus cost price. Profit is equals to, you can find profit means P. Profit P is equals to, yes, selling price minus cost price. I told you, what is cost price? The wholesaler who picks the rate of the goods, that is the cost price. And the man who sells, he purchases from a wholesaler and he selling, he sells a price for the higher, little higher, then we can call as it is selling price SP minus CP. That is P is equals to, P is equals to SP minus CP. SP is selling price, CP is cost price. Loss, loss means what here? Yes, that is the price. A price is lesser than, a price lesser than cost price. Lesser than a cost price is called loss. Yes, this one you can say loss L. Loss means L. Loss L is equals to, we can write, yes, CP minus, here selling price SP. Yes, selling price, or sorry, cost price minus, here lesser the cost price minus selling price. It is more here, cost price is more. That is, L is equals to loss CP minus SP. CP minus SP. Write this neatly in your notebook. Write this. Very important. These are, what is the cost price? Cost price, who picks the rate of a thing, object, that is by the wholesaler. And this is customer who, yes, purchases for the, yes, we can say profit is equal to selling price minus cost price. That is P equal to selling price minus cost price. If the loss is there, then you can say loss equals to cost price minus selling price. What is loss? Loss is, it is the a price lesser than the selling price, lesser than the cost price. That is, a price means it is selling price lesser than the cost price, then we will get a loss. Here profit means a selling price is a greater than the cost price. Yes, we'll solve the examples on this, then we can come to know it is a very easy topic only. Here see some examples, write these neatly. Yes. Find the profit or the loss. You take these two notes. If selling price is greater than CP. It is greater than CP. Is profit only. This is profit. It is a profit or a gain. You write. It is a profit or gain. You can write profit or gain, that is P. Yes or no? If the CP is greater than SP, CP is greater than cost price is more than selling price, it is loss. It is a loss. We can write L. Yes or no? It is a loss. You should know these two. If SP is selling price is greater than CP, means you should write P is equals to SP minus CP. Yes, it is a P means profit. If CP is greater than SP, then CP minus SP. Cost price minus selling price, then it is a loss. With these two formulae, we can calculate the profit or a loss. Here there are some questions. Write down this one. Yes. Okay. There are some problems. You can find it's a profit or a loss. They will give a cost price and selling price. You can find it's a loss or a profit. Is it loss or a profit? Let's find the profit or the loss. Find the profit or a loss. You should find, is it profit or loss? The cost price A. The cost price is in rupees. Yes. CP is equals to rupees of 75. And SP selling price, it is rupees of 80. Yes. Here see, compare these two, cost price and yes, selling price. Here selling price is greater than yes cost price. Then we know that yes, SP is equals to, you have write P is equals to SP minus CP. Yes, that is profit. And L, loss, CP minus SP. Here SP is greater than the CP, then write profit P is equals to SP minus CP, that is 80 minus rupees 80 minus 75. Rupees 75. What is the difference? Rupees of 5. Therefore, profit is equals to 5 rupees. There is a profit of 5. Very simple, no? Yes. B question. They will give the both SP and CP. 120 is the CP. Cost price 120. And selling price is rupees of 130. Yes, here also it is greater. SP is greater. Then we can find profit. Profit is equals to SP minus CP. That is rupees of 130 minus rupees of 120. We can write 10 rupees is the profit. There is a profit of 10 rupees. Very simple problems. Yes or no? Just compare greater, smaller, like that. Here we can write SP is greater than CP. Here CP is greater than SP. That much only. Yes, write down these two also. We will see some more examples. Very easy. if the cost price and selling price given, we can find its a profit or a loss. Yes. Next, the CP is 90 rupees, SP is 85. Cost price CP is equals to 90, selling price is equals to 85. Here see, SP is, CP is greater than, CP is greater than SP, then we have to subtract loss. It is here is the loss, L is equals to CP minus SP, then 90 minus rupees of 90 minus rupees of 85. Yes, we can find the difference is 5 rupees loss. There is a loss of 5 rupees. Yes, D, very simple question. 80 is the cost price and selling price is 75 is the, so 76 is the selling price. Then we can, it is also a loss only, we can write L is equals to CP minus SP, that is 80 minus rupees of 80 minus rupees of 76, 4 rupees is a loss. There is a loss of 4 rupees. Yes or no? Yes. After this, two more examples E and F will see. Remaining you can solve as a homework. So easy questions. E, decimal points. 32 rupees. CP is equals to rupees of 32.75 and SP is equals to rupees of, yes, 34.25. Yes, here selling price is more than the cost price. Then here, what is the loss or profit? Good. Profit is equals to SP minus CP. SP is 34.25 minus, what is that? Yes, 32 rupees, 32.75. Here only we can find minus. Yes, then 5 minus 5 is 0. 2 minus 7 it is. Think 2 minus 7 not possible. Then we can 12. Think it is 12. Then it is 3. 3 minus 2 it is 1. 12 minus 7 is 5. Yes, 3 minus 3. Arrange neatly. 3 minus 3 it is 0. We can write 1.05 is the gain here. Gain means profit of P is equals to rupees of 1.50. 1.50 is the profit here. Yes, write down this. Write neatly in your notebook. Yes, after this, we'll go with the one more example of F. Very simple is finding profit or a loss. Yes, 80.20 rupees cost price. 80.20 cost price and selling price is rupees of 74.60. Then here SP is lesser than cost price, then it is a loss. What is the formula for to get the loss? Yes, CP minus SP. Then what is the CP? Write CP, arrange in a column, 80 rupees minus 80.20 minus 74 rupees 60. Yes. Subtract. Then you will get the loss. L is equals to 0 minus 0, 0. 2 minus 6 not possible, 12, then it is 9, it is 7. 12 minus 6, 6 decimal point, 9 minus 4, 5, 7 minus 7, 0. What is here? Therefore, loss of 5 rupees and 60 paise, that is 5.60 rupees, there is a loss because SP selling price is lesser than the cost price. And one more thing, very simple questions these are. Yes or no? Yes. 214 CP rupees 214.85 SP, that is of rupees, yes, 221.75. Here 14 is a lesser than CP, is lesser than selling price, then we will get a profit. Profit P is equal to SP minus CP, then 221.75 minus of 214.85. Yes, we will get a profit. 5 minus 5, 0, 7 minus 8 not possible, 17, it is 0, 0 minus 4 again not possible, then it is 10, borrowed from 2. Yes, then 17 minus 8, 9, decimal, 10 minus 4, 6, then 1 minus 1, 0, 2 minus 2, 0. How much profit? He gets profit of 6.90 rupees. Profit is 6.90. Simple one. And last one, F, sorry, H1. Yes, write neatly these questions. For this 6.60, CP is equal to 46.60 and SP selling price is 49.85. Yes, then what is the loss or profit? Good. Here there is a profit. Why? Correct. Selling price is greater than cost price. Therefore, 49.85 rupees, both are in rupees only. Rupees I am right, rupees of 49.85 minus 46.60. 5, 2, 3, yes. Therefore, P is equal to rupees of 3.25. You can write the profit 3.25. Very simple now. Yes? Any doubt? If you have doubt, you can give a call to me. Write down. Write this one neatly in your notebook. Yes? After this, you can solve some stories. They are given here directly CP and SP. If they give in a word problem, that word problem you can solve so easy. That is also, you should need to be understand which is the cost price and which is the selling price. If you got cost price and selling price, by applying this formula, you can find it loss or profit very easily. Quickly, we can find. Here, find the profit or the loss. Find the profit or the loss. There is a loss or a profit. You should find it. Question. Anusha bought. Write the story problem. Write neatly in your notebook. A sofa for, yes, for rupees of 4850. She sold it for rupees, yes, 5000. 90. Yes. See, compare the both the amounts. See, Anusha bought for sofa 4850 and she sold it for 5000. Yes, here selling price is greater than the cost price. The cost price is 4850. Then she sold. Which is the selling price? 5000. Yes, 790. Here you write cost price is equals to rupees of 4850. Then selling price, that is SP, that is equals to 5790. Then automatically SP is greater than CP. Then there is a what? Profit. P is equals to SP minus CP. SP is what here? Yes, we can write 5790 minus rupees of 4850. This is the profit. Therefore, 0 minus 0, 0, 9 minus 5, 4, 7 minus 8, not possible, is 17. Then it is 4. 17 minus 8 is 9. Yes. Then 4 minus 4, 0. Therefore, rupees. There is a Anusha got the profit. Therefore, profit is equals to, we can write, profit is rupees of 940. 940 rupees. She got the, Anusha got a profit. Because here 4850, it is lesser than the selling price, 5790. Write this one in your notebook. Yes. Okay, next one. Same questions. Very easy questions, these. Easy stories. Yes. Rishi had a necklace costing of 5785 Rishi. Yes. Rishi had a necklace of costing rupees, yes, 5785, and she sold it for rupees of 5280. Yes, here cost price is what? She had a necklace of costing, this is the cost price. She sold, that is the selling price. Then write cost price CP is equals to rupees 5785 and SP selling price is equals to rupees of 5280. There is a loss. Why? CP is lesser than, sorry, SP is lesser than CP, or CP is greater here. Then L is equals to CP minus SP. That is CP is 5785 minus 5280. What is the amount she lost? Yes, 5 minus 0 is 5, 8 minus 8 is 0, 7 minus 3 is 5, 5 minus 5 is 0. Then she lost of 505 rupees. You can write Rishi lost rupees 505. Who lost? Yes, Rishi lost rupees of 505. Very simple. Yes, take down this one also in your notebook. Write neatly. Any doubt? No doubt? Okay, let's see one more problem. Very easy. Sheet 1. Robson bought a jacket for yes. Robson bought a jacket for rupees of a jacket. Jacket for rupees of yes 1475. And sold it for and sold it for rupees of 1655. Yes, Robson bought the jacket for 1475 and he sold it for 1655. Then write CP cost prices. He bought for how much rupees? 1475. Yes, and he sold selling price rupees of 1655. Here SP is greater than CP. Automatically you can say he got the yes he gained. He gained how much? He gained that you have to calculate. Profit is equals to yes SP minus CP. That is SP is 1655 minus CP 1475. Automatically we can calculate the how much he profit. That's 5 minus 5 0 15. Then it is 5. 15 minus 7 is 8. 5 minus 4 1. 1 minus 1 0. Therefore profit is equals to profit is rupees of 180. He got the profit of 180. Yes, right. After this they will give both yes selling price and cost price. That's very easy. Here see loss they will give and cost price they will give. You should find the selling price like that. Here very easy this. This formula will readjust with the see here first CP minus SP minus CP. SP selling price minus cost price. What is this? SP is greater means it is a profit. Yes, they were given a profit. Yes, if you want to find yes CP is equals to we can write CP is equals to yes cost price is equals to profit minus selling price. Sorry. Selling price minus profit. Yes, CP you want to know? Yes, just you move it this side. Then you can write SP here, not CP. SP is equals to selling price is equals to here profit plus cost price. SP. If you want to find SP, yes, profit plus cost price. Or if you want to find CP, then cost price, if you want to find, we can write CP is equals to selling price minus profit. Selling price minus profit. These two formulas also you should remember. SP if you want to find, then SP is equals to P plus CP. P plus CP, then CP you want to find CP minus P. If second one loss, in the loss, yes, you can write CP minus SP is equals to loss. Cost price minus yes SP, selling price is equals to loss. Then therefore CP is equals to take this side. Then it will cost price is equals to loss plus selling price. Or if you want to find selling price means CP minus loss. CP minus loss. These four also you should know this one. We rearrange it here only. Yes, then we got the this formulas. If you want to purchase, if you want to know selling price, then CP minus loss in the loss. in the profit, yes, selling price is equals to, yes, CP, cost price, selling price minus profit. If you want to calculate in the profit, selling price minus, yes, profit, in the loss, selling price minus loss, that is the selling price, CP, cost price minus loss. Here some examples, that's very easy. Find the cost price or the selling price, both they will give you, loss they will give you, yes. Here there is a table, find the cost price or a selling price. This one you write, find the cost price or the selling price. If you want to find a cost price or a selling price, they will give cost price of rupees, CP here. CP is, it is in rupees, here SP, it is in rupees, P means profit, L, yes, A, 110 rupees is the cost price, then profit is 5 rupees, profit is 5 rupees. What formula we have here? Yes, we have a formula to get SP in profit, profit given. This is not applicable. Here loss no, import only profit. Then add both, CP is equals to P plus SP plus CP. CP is given, SP is equals to, SP you want means this one you apply, that is 110 plus 110 plus 5, that is 115. We can write 110 is equals to 110 plus 5, it is. These two you add. If they will given a loss, like that example. Yes, 150 is the cost price. Here selling price is, you should find profit, no profit, loss. Loss of 20 rupees. Then, yes, cost price is 150. Selling price minus, you do this one, SP is equals to CP, 150 minus 20, that is 130. She sold it for 130 rupees. Very simple. You apply these four formulas. Yes, see one. Yes, CP is not given. Selling price is 99. Selling price is 99. And profit of 3 rupees. Profit of 3 rupees, here there is no loss, profit. Then CP, CP is equals to SP, P plus, sorry, CP, you want CP, SP minus P. SP is selling price minus this profit, then you will get a CP, this formula you apply, 99 minus 3, it is 96. 96 rupees of cost price. Very simple, no? By adjusting the values, here only we can find the selling price or a cost price. Cost price or selling price. Yes, like these examples are there. Yes, I will send as a homework. You can take this as a homework. And some more examples and about the homework I will give in the next section. Homework I will give in the next section. Yes, with this I will conclude today's class. Okay, thank you.